questions to you, and I will expect different kind of answers from every one of you. So, let's start with the first question. Did you all keenly listen to my introduction?
Yes.
Can you name few of my hobbies?
Football.
Not in random, guys. I hate it. So someone can just raise it and just.
Football and watching TV shows.
Footy.
Great. So do you guys know which football club you support?
No.
Do you know which kind of cuisine do I like?
Italian.
Biryani.
So, but just randomly saying few things, it's very difficult to know what you're about to witness. Maybe a particular product, a particular person, or a session, whatever it is. If you just say it out, it just stays in your mind for a few fraction of seconds. If I ask you the same question after 5-10 minutes, you'll hardly remember my hobbies. Probably you'll hardly remember my name. So that's the common thing when you just hear something. But when you visually look at something, when you see something, that's when it creates impact. That's where it stays in your heart. And PR is all about that. Visually creating an impact within your viewers and winning their hearts. That's all about PR. So I'm here to give you tips and make you learn how to win hearts through PR. So, what is the most keen and important thing about PR, public relation? What is vital, the most important thing about PR? Answers.
Creating a buzz.
Conveying what exactly you need to convey.
Perfect.
Maintaining rapport with members and also guests.
Some extent, yeah.
Timing.
But the core value about PR is marketing. What is marketing? What does marketing mean to you? I hope there are marketing analysts, marketing people over here. So you can just give random answers about what is marketing.
Putting people.
Giving right to the right people. Jain sir.
Marketing means Jain.
Toss the coin.
A couple of more answers.
Stupendously selling something.
That's a good answer. So marketing means selling a product, creating an impact, creating awareness, making people know about something new that is going to come up. This is all about marketing. This is all we've known about marketing. So going with the textbook definition of what marketing is a business process wherein you communicate with the people, create an impact with the people, and sell your product, your service, whatever it is. That is all about marketing. So marketing plays a key role in winning the hearts, winning whatever customer it is. Because for every organization, each and every, let it be a Toastmaster club, or organization, or club, or shop, whatever it is, customers are the king. If you visit to Taj Hotels, Taj Group of Hotels, let it be any, Taj Coromandel, Taj Karimara, Taj Maha Palace Hotel in Mumbai, you know one quote that they use always. Can any one of you guess what's the quote? Sorry.
Is it customer is king?
You're close actually.
Customer is king.
Always.
They say customers and clients are gods. That's the key thing about themselves which makes them one of the best and finest hotel organization in India. None of the hotel organization have ever met to their expectations or brought them down. They still are the best hotel organization throughout India because they consider their customers as gods. Okay, so I'll ask one more question. What do you all do? Okay, before asking this, I'll ask a couple of people a different questions. How many of you are married couples?
Married couples, sir.
I mean married.
One marriage.
Both hands.
Newly married.
Just 4 years ago.
Who are singles but committed?
Wrong question.
Raghavan.
Good boy.
Whatever. No one tells that.
Come on, don't be rich. will shy about it. Don't reveal this out to anyone. You can openly
tell themselves. Don't be fair. Tell you don't fail.
And who are singles. So generally.
Dude, that's a
we have to wait for. So
that's like 90% of the audience.
Exactly. So what do you all do to win hearts of your loved ones, your partners, or your girlfriend or boyfriend? What do you all do?
Say lies. Tell lies.
Tell lies. Second, few more answers. What do you do? What do you do to win their hearts? Come on, sir, you said you're committed.
Give them what they do.
Perfect.
Give them what they like.
Married people, you can say what you do to win your heart of your wife.
I think we did that before, not after.
Father usually stays quiet.
Stays quiet, yeah.
Buying lipsticks.
I only.
Okay.
I just agree. That's it.
Just agree. Woo!
In marketing and PR, you need to know your audience, you need to know your customers before you sell anything to them. So the next key important about PR is knowing your audience. So knowing your audience plays a very important role in winning the hearts of your customer, your members, your fellow beings, your partners, no matter who they are. So for winning hearts, you need to do a lot of things. Because you can't win hard just like a snap of a finger. You need to do a lot of work, you need to do a lot of research, you need to understand about your customers. When it comes to your partners, you need to know what your partners like, what your partner dislikes. If you do something wrong, that's it, you're done. You know how it is, you're done. Like, you get a message saying that, maybe we need to talk. That's more than enough. That message is like a war, you're entering into a war zone. Similarly, like, for winning customers, you need to know. You need to know them really well. So for knowing them, there are a few key things that I'm going to talk about right now. So these are the three key important things to understand your customer well and deliver what they want. So first is the age group. Whenever you're coming up with a service or a product or whatever it is, you need to know the audience you're going to approach. So for approaching the audience, you need to understand the age group. For example, you come up with something really catchy, for example, an iWatch, and go to a 16-year-old guy, say that, hey, look up, this is an iWatch, and this has so many features. Do you think that particular person would buy it? You just shoo you away, saying that, don't waste my time. I've already got a precious watch with me, so please go away. And you're selling a watch for 50,000, who buys it? But the same, when you go and deliver it to a youngster who's 20, 25 plus, you'll be able to sell it in much better manner. So knowing the age group of the audience plays a much important role. The second is the likes and dislikes. You need to know what are the likings of people. When you're approaching a large number of people, a huge crowd, you need to know what are the likes, what are the dislikes. Because if you portray something that they hate, that they're not okay with, then that's it, you're failed as a person who's trying to win hearts. Let it be in a relationship, let it be in selling a service or product, you just fail over there. So you need to do a careful research before approaching your audience or no matter who it is. And the final most thing is trends. Trends is a recent thing that came up because nowadays people go up with the latest trends that they want. Trends capture the audience much quicker than other types of marketing techniques or other types of PR techniques. So you need to understand these three main things to sell a product or sell a service. When it comes to Toastmasters group, you need to, these three key things play an important role. Age groups, likes and dislikes, and trends. That's how you do a good PR for your club. After knowing your audience, what are the other things that you do to win hearts? You apply key techniques to implement these three things. So to apply these key techniques, you need few other more techniques that helps in achieving these particular things. So these are known as the best practices. Creativity, design, right visuals and materials, and using the right tools. Going with the creativity. Creativity plays a very, very important role in PR and marketing activities. Why? You can present someone with a big essay or big write-up saying that this is the product. But nowadays, who reads a lot? Who reads everything line by line? No one. We hardly get time to read newspapers. Nowadays, we just open our mobile, see a headline, and say, oh, there's a bomb blast over here. Oh, there's a water crisis over here. That's how we do it. But we don't read line to line. So creativity helps you convey the message in a much visual manner. You just put up a good image, an image that's going to portray, that's going to sell your service or product. You didn't even have any writer. The person who views that particular poster or the banner or whatever it is understands what he wants, what you're trying to sell to them. So creativity plays an important role. Second, designing. Designing is at another really difficult task, but plays a much more important role. I am not a designer by profession. I work with numbers. I'm a financial guy. But now I have been recognized for my PR activities, and people ask me that, am I a professional designer? I recently got a job offer saying that, why don't you join my firm for designing purpose? I was like, no boss, I'm a financial guy, I'm not a designer. So design plays a key important role. So you need to be well versed with designing. In the further slides, I'm going to tell you how you can design in a much easier and quicker manner. Are there any VPPRs over here?
No.
I have only tracks. So the next thing is write visuals and materials. So sometimes few visuals make people fringe. They don't like what they see. So you need to that's why I said you need to understand your audience before presenting the visual or presenting the material that you want to present to them. So you need to be careful about what you choose. And the final thing is using the right tools. Tools as in, when it comes to designing, there are n number of tools available out there. But we are not aware of those tools. These tools help you in designing, achieving all those three main categories. That is creativity, design, and using right visuals and materials. So now I'm going to show you few stupendous posters that were made by few of my team members and I. So I just want you guys to guess which tools were used to present this particular posters. Wild guess, guys. Just
PowerPoint.
Poster my wall.
Poster my wall. Okay.
PowerPoint.
So which one are you saying? Okay, first this one.
This one.
Which tool do you use? Poster my wall.
Canva.
Canva. Okay.
PowerPoint.
I don't want Rags to answer.
PowerPoint.
PowerPoint. Okay. Paint. What about that poster?
Photoshop.
This particular poster was created in an app called Sketch. It's available in MacBook. It's a simple app just like how MS Paint is in for Mac. So this was created in Sketch and that one was created in Canva. People really thought that was created in Photoshop, but it was created in Canva. Next slide, please. This one. Again.
PowerPoint.
Photoshop. This one was created in an app called Adobe XD. It's a simple app, much lesser version of Photoshop and much easier and user friendly. And that one was also created in Illustrator, Adobe Illustrator. The next slide. This one. I want you to especially guess which app was used for this particular poster. Just look at the design, look at how it's been presented, the placing of products, I mean the images and wordings, everything. So this particular poster was created in PPT. For the first time when I saw this poster, I hardly believed it. So this poster was created by one of my team members, my very good friend Toastmaster Yasir from Hill Capital Toastmaster Club, Sri Lanka. And he was the one who won 5 consecutive Best Flyer Award in 2018-19. And our PRM manager, Thomas Abraham, gave a special recognition for him for creating such beautiful flyers with just PPT, not even Photoshop. I use a lot of tools, but he just did this stupendous flyer with just PPT. So this is how you present products, this is how you present the posters, with using just minute and simple tools. All you need is good creativity, good thought process, and right tools and visuals to come up with such great work. The next slide is challenges. We all face challenges in winning hearts. Let it be a relationship, let it be customers. In relationship, we find it so difficult to convince our partners or our loved ones. Similarly, convincing our customers is a much more bigger challenge for us. So these two main things are the challenges when it comes to PR activities. So brand value and time management. Brand value, Toastmasters are really keen when it comes to brand value. You can't place Toastmaster logo, the TLI logo, wherever you wish you want to place it. Well, if the PRM of a district sees it, he'll immediately mail you saying that what you've done is wrong, please remove that poster from wherever you've shared it, in all the social media. Not just with Toastmasters, in any organization, they are very keen with their branding value. How well you place their logo, how well you portray their posters. When it comes out in newspapers, when it comes out in large boardings and banners outside, people look at it. So you have to be very careful about branding. So the branding value plays an important role. So that's the main challenge that people face it. So before you start designing or do marketing, you need to know the brand value of your client. Second is the time management. We all complain saying that I don't have time, even my time is up, my health card is up. So I'll just finish it, just a minute. So we all complain saying that I don't have much time. I don't have enough time to balance my life with when it comes to Toastmaster, career, professional life or personal life. Initially when I was VP PR, I used to complain the same. But I would agree that PR was the platform which taught me how to manage my time. I used to do my PR activities for my club, area, division and district, focus on my career, focus on my studies and focus on my personal life. I never compromised anything. I balanced everything and that's how I won all the hearts. Woo! So with this, I would like to end my session. If you guys have any questions that you want to ask me about PR related or how well to present or anything, how well to promote your club, anything about Toastmastering, I'll be available offline after this meeting, so I'll catch up with you guys. So thank you very much, you guys, all very lovely audience, so thanks a lot. Thank you.